Hello, and welcome to my base tour. But before we get into the video, would you please make sure to subscribe if you're not already? It's free, and you can always unsubscribe later. Now, let's get back into the video. Okay, welcome to the base tour. So, first, we have my house up there. And then we have this nice little bridge with a nice staircase, nicely decorated. And then, boom, right to the house. This is a chicken coop or whatever you want to. It's just to get eggs. I need wither roses, so I'm going to get a bunch of eggs. And then once I fight another wither, I'll get a bunch of wither roses if I just throw all those eggs down and get a bunch of chickens. Alright, so first we have the first floor. Got a little nice TV set, some shelving, decoration, and then a little backyard. Nice little pond. I need to fix this. It used to look a lot nicer. Then I took down a bunch of trees along here and it just doesn't look as nice. So yeah, get that looking nicer. And then first we'll go upstairs. So got my bed, few decoration things. And then for utilities, like stuff we're actually gonna stuff we actually like use on my server. We just got a bunch of random chests up here, filled with stuff, enchanting, all your necessities, ender chests. And we also have vanilla tweaks installed, which is like data packs, so we have custom mob heads, like multiplayer sleep, and now we'll go downstairs. So we got your ordinary basement, it looks like your ordinary basement. However, we kind of have something shady going on here, so if we open up this, there's a button. Open up the bookcase and we start going down, and now we have a villager trading house, because I want to keep this on the down low. I don't want people to know I just got 15-20 villagers in my basement. That's kind of a weird thing to have. Right here on this water line, there's a villager breeder all the way up there, so usually I just like tower up, there's like a tunnel back there, I tower up and then I go breed them, and then the villager babies will fall down here and then add them into a slot. So if we come down here, got a little tunnel down here that just leads to the same place. I'm going this way. This is where I have a few farms. So first of all, iron golem farm, got the zombie, the villagers, and then the iron golem will spawn and go into a lava pit there, and then grab all the items. And then right here behind this wall, or actually that wall back there, so like basically right here, so you can see a skeleton spawner back here, they just filter into there. Basically all the items kind of drop down here. There's a hopper like system you can kind of see right there. It feeds into a dropper beta that sends it up into a water stream, and then same thing with the iron golem loot. It goes into this water stream. There's a sorting system back here, and then it sorts it into these chests. So we have a bunch of iron, then a bunch of bones. And then eventually I'm gonna add like another farm, probably like, I was thinking like an automatic wheat farm or something, and then AFK room over here. Alright, and then I guess I can show you the nether. It's not anything special, so yeah. Alright, if we take this way though, we can go up to the surface and back to the house, so. Alright, and then we go through this portal. Alright, so we pop through this portal, and then I kind of made a little decoration back there. There's a little mine down there, but yeah, we pop back up here, and it's just right down here from the house, so pretty close. I started to make a like custom village. This is a bakery. This is Gustavo's bakery. I don't have any villagers in here yet, cause I want to like zombie proof it. But you can kind of see like his store down here, his little bedroom, and he's got like storage up here. And then we walk along the little pathway. And we got Gregory the blacksmith. So this is a little work area. Does all his work over here. Made a sword. Little storage area. We got his house over here. Kind of come up these stairs. Little couch. Got a little kitchen area. Then we come up here. His bedroom. And then he's got a little farm up top. If we go down, we find the basement. It's a little cellar. And then this way, if we come this way, got a little public library in the works. It's not finished yet. I kind of haven't finished this building. Kind of little reception area. Come up here. Got some books, little nook to look out and kind of see the scenery. I'm gonna finish this off. This is gonna be the mayor's house. So we got this is the town hall right there. So his house will be right here, kind of finish this building off, so it's kind of connected to this. Right here next to the town hall, we have a little public park area. Just a nice view of the scenery. And then we come into the town hall. Got a little town hall reception. And then we got like a podium, I would say. Like if you're going to give a speech, let's say the mayor's going to give a speech, he'll stand up here. And little people can watch. It could also be used as a church, I would assume. Got two viewing areas up here, so you can kind of sit up here, watch from up here. Over here, same thing. We got the mayor's office. This is kind of glitchy, but I wanted this to kind of look like paper and pen, so it's just kind of cool. Little desk. Over here is what I'm most proud about. You can't even see it, but I made a custom cliff, and it's the first time I've ever done anything like this. I was super surprised at how well it turned out. I got a lot of inspiration from Good Times with Scar, kind of this little dirt pattern. I know he does that a lot. Over to the farming area. This is where we started the tour off, right here. So if we come this way, we have a barn I built up. So here's the barn. It looks kind of ordinary. This is a large hay bale stack, but if we take out my netherite hoe and I hoe that piece of land, we're in a secret area. So if we come down here, I haven't done anything here yet. I was thinking of putting some other farms down here in this area. Just another area for farms. I don't like to make farms, like efficient farms, like in the open, because I just don't think they look that good. So I always try and hide them underneath the ground. Probably should decorate it some more. It doesn't look too good, but it's not too bad. This is my friend's house. So before there was a lake here, there was kind of just a little ravine here, and my friend built this room around the cave, kind of just following the shape of the cave. And as a prank, I decided to just put his whole base underneath a lake. Kind of just decided to go with it. I added this so he could actually get into his base, because I kind of felt bad that I just put his whole base underneath a lake. I added this little thing, and now this is just how he gets into his base. He built this whole windmill. It's pretty cool. I think he got a tutorial, but it still looks super nice. If we come down here, he's kind of just got a little area down here. I don't know what he's doing with this. He's had this for a while, and he kind of just hasn't done anything with it. Same with this. He hasn't done anything, but he does have a skeleton spawner over here, so that's pretty nice. If we go upstairs, we come into the main part of the house, or the windmill. I don't know what he's doing with the beds over here. It's kind of weird. But he's got a nice little kitchen, some like random stuff, and then he's got this huge storage system. He's still trying to organize it right now, but it's looking pretty good. Just random stuff. This is the one fun part about his base. You go right out of there. Move on to the big project that's being worked on over here. We have a chest pyramid, as it appears. This used to be a mountain, and I leveled it, and then I put a bunch of grass on here. I plan on building Whoville from the Grinch, like, in this area. I thought it would be super cool, because that's kind of like one of my favorite Christmas movies. It'd be an awesome project here. Over here, we're building the Grinch's mountain. It doesn't really fit in with the landscape right now. I'm going to try and like blend it into the actual part of the mountain. I'm going to make like a little land bridge right there, and then kind of zigzag and then make his door around that area. And then kind of a pathway coming along here, and then Whoville will be right there, which I think will look really cool. Then we'll have a bridge right here that will close this gap, and you'll have a little pathway into Whoville. It's going to be a huge project. I don't even know if I'm going to finish it before Christmas, but I don't know, I think it'll still be a cool project. Just have a whole Christmas area. Okay, now I'm gonna show you guys the creeper farm. So I'm gonna take some rockets. Oh, I'm actually gonna get some more rockets, actually. I need lots of rockets for this trip over here. It's pretty far away. And then here is the creeper farm. So it's really just for rockets. I don't use it for anything else. So I plan on taking this and kind of making a dropper vader. It just goes up to the top. The AFK platform. So if we go up here, we kind of have a jumbled mess. So this is the AFK room. Keep your stuff in here. And then I just kind of added a sugarcane farm over here, because I was like, if I'm gonna AFK over here, I might as well add a little sugarcane farm over here. But yeah, let's go back to the base. Okay, so I got one last thing to show you guys. So I'm gonna show you guys the Enderman farm. That's where I get all my XP. But yeah, we just come out here. Lots of Ender pearls over here. All the farms in this world that I've shown you are designed by Shulkercraft. So if you wanna go look him up, I'll make sure to put a link to his channel in the description. If you wanna build some farms that are simple and efficient, so yeah, they get the job done. All right, so that's the end of the tour. I don't really have anything else to show you in my world. I kind of just went through everything. So if you're new to my channel, I'd very much appreciate if you would subscribe, leave a like. You can always unsubscribe and you can always unlike the video if you want to. Yeah, so I've been Renomus Rex. See you guys in the next one. Peace.